All the individual persons' names that I'll call are the ones that were induced while they were babies and visiting the old Carver Park housing projects in the 1950s and the 1960s. Some were teenagers and some were just at the age of 21. Jesse Pim, just at the age of 20 or 21 years old, when he began his career as a maintenance man for the Carver County Metropolitan Housing Authority. They changed the name several times, so they got where they're at now. I mean, you can see the photo or picture of him. This is Jesse Pim. Like they took with the Brinks and Steel Machine at the request of Kennard McGuffey, who told him that he was going to make him kill his girlfriend one day. This is why, years later, killing his girlfriend with a double-barreled shotgun on Buckeye Avenue at the Buckeye Laundromat. This young lady, same day, visited the old Carver project when she was just a baby, and her mother brought her down to meet me, and one of the family members of the Blackstone Baptist Church. They made her quite a good trip. They made her hang around Margaret McGee, Bill Robinson, and Kennard McGuffey. They really started to go ahead to use her to smoke crack and make other women living in the other district. This young lady, Francine Greenley, was stolen from Birmingham to the old Carver project by Judge Patricia Blackman from her church to get her in what they call a red zone, but they can get her hooked on crack, so they can give her character inside her head to make her a lesbian and all that screw up inside her head. Detective Curtis Watkins said this young girl, he wanted her to smoke crack until she died. So she smoked crack until she died. This is a photo of the late Sammy Lewis, who had got her into the Carver project. She had got her into her daughter, and they were going to smoke crack and be a lesbian and help them steal people's babies out the Carver House and fight that. Also, Jackie Reeves involved in the Bruce Store system and being used by a corrupt system. This woman and her husband were set up by telephone calls to go somewhere to see them going up to police. We need to do some more time with building and others on the telephone to get them out of town so they can take their lives. These are the siblings of Karen Bloom. This is Wilma Cohen, came off East 36th Street to Central Avenue, who they made a crackhead out of, and a lesbian, and a prostitute. There's Anthony Sewell, who also lived on East 36th Street. He was here at the set. And he was told he would make him kill somebody, a whole lot of women in his lifetime. There's a photo of a Jasmine Wilson. He was said, the last time I saw Jasmine, she was a little girl. And she was talking to her face with the Race to Score machine. They finally gave Jasmine a record of being violent because they tormented her and thought they were looking violent. There's a picture of Linda Berry, who also visited me at the old Carver Housing Project when she was a little girl, and she was being put by you say the pastor's name is Kamal McDuffie. He was right on the symptom, beat them and beat their mother up. Her sister-in-law and her were found in the home of Audrey Sears. Your mother told me as a police to go over there and get her food orders out, and I did. 2 times. Everybody that could not make Jeffrey Cook, they tried to kill or make a crack addicted. The review does not look like this to this very day. She's in rehab right now. This is Marshall Bill, who I worked at Premium Settlement at 2382 Harmon Road. The address is now changed because they have a new filling in. Marshall is caught coming to the Carver project as a teen. He'll be now like 14, 15, 16 years old. He went back to his village at the same age and picked up his wife at Premium. And he attached his head again, I guess he's finding what they like to do with. And then Marshall killed his wife, Rebecca, a school teacher. Rebecca's father was the assistant principal in the same area, in the city area, on East 55th, the principal of George Washington Carver Elementary School. Here's a photo of the 11 women Kennard faculty took from the detective Curtis Watson. This is David, one I know for sure. He said he wanted Amanda. He tried to pump fat girls and beat her up too. Trying to make all of them pumps and fast so they don't sit them, they don't talk to their head. But this will come from the Albert Holmes project that is that owned his family. And his sister got killed. I mean, he said that I make her sell crack or film and make her meet with her to take her life. The sister of Mary Jane was found dead. Here's Will Stokes to approach me and Will Boy. He told me to get paid for 10 more black boys like me. A lot of money. And he was operated by the Dave and the Fed Devils and the prosecutors of Carver County and the municipal court. Here's Walter Dozier. He lived in the same apartment building I lived in at 2407 on the road on the first floor. So they attacked his head and said they wanted him to kill somebody on his future date. He wound up killing his girlfriend in 2004. We also got on to former Sheriff Will T. McFarr and his family, who also stayed in the old Carver housing project. They set this young sheriff up and think that he would never be able to do anything after they put his line on him. They set two set situations up inside their head and make them obey. He said, "This is a young man that stole my life and raped some things under the age of 18, and Rick Michelle told, Rick Francine Germany, and Rick Latina Germany, in my presence. This is almost sexual to be stuck in his bowhole. He was a county executive, Edward Fitzgerald. He was seen beaten black from the old Carver project and selling crack cocaine. He continued to file the cocaine crack selling with the Carver building to this very day. Him and Will Stokes. It's Albert Germany. He lives on Quimby Avenue, down the street from us again, and my family. Who I used to go to the store for, to get a cigarette. Get a note. They doom and doom and doom. And they won't commit murder also. They still got his family members attached to the Winston score machine who cannot often do a life on the other side. The epistle of Lord Adam, who stood much differently also. They told him in craft and they wanted him to kill somebody in his lifetime. Later on in his lifetime, Lord did kill somebody. Lord told me one day while he was laying down in the playground, he said he was talking to his head and moving his mouth. And the later pastor Scott Gavin said, he said they talked to his head again. Someone boarded a scene, sticking that machine that they pulled my teeth off to his brother, Mark Adam, who is now also deceased. Mark got a lung problem by someone sticking in his chest and back to that machine on Central Avenue. They took the brother, the brother of Shirley Stupin, who also lived in the old Carver Housing Project. They attacked every resident in there to make them obey them, even as judges. They made her brother sell crack in the old Carver Project, and they made him sell crack in the Mount Pleasant area. They got her own to Council President George Ford to hold that legislation. The blacks are supposed to be ruined by this girl, Chuck Lewis Ford. He also has personal knowledge of the use of the race to score machine and he operated it, along with Detective Mark Cross, another faggot. They got a hold to Michael White. They got a hold to George Zimmer Taylor. They got a hold to Stephen Taylor Jones to lie through her mouth. They got a hold to the official black men to outrun their system, attending niggas and talking to their ears, and kidnapping little boys and little girls and having drug addicted women killed. They got a hold of my brother, Herbert Drake. They got a hold of my cousin, Maria, while they were residents in the old Carver Project, moving on telephone and looking up on the street. Also, Richard little boy told me that they're looking him. He was among Bridget Brown when he talked to her person. Her mother was pregnant when they walked through the Carver Project. Now she talks to her voice like Anthony. My thoughts were using Sherlock. I saw her at Sherlock on his 51st Street. And Detective Mark Cross and put his head up her desk to suck her down. Mark Cross went to jail. Someone brought him to selling drugs in a Carver Project 650 and Elfrid. He's never resident of the East 36th and 50th, the Timmy's Lemon, who they also used, trying to make a prostitute out of baby and a lesbian. He depicted Lewis Stokes and Edward Fitzgerald, the two sides together being sworn in at the flag ceremony.